Construction has begun on the Ædna Lab, part of the Future Food Beacon. Housed in the Limes building at Sutton Bonington Campus, we are building a dedicated clean facility for the isolation of ancient and environmental DNA. With the lab coming online by the end of 2021, we caught up with Andrew Clark to see how the building works are progressing.
So I've just come through the main door and the entry room where I will have removed my shoes, and into here, the changing room where I'll put on the bodysuit, hairnet, face mask and first pair of gloves. So I've just walked through from the changing room to the main clean room, and this is where initial sample preparation will take place, including weighing and photography of samples. So I'm now standing in one of two of the dedicated ultra-clean labs. The first lab will be used for DNA extraction, the second for downstream molecular steps required prior to DNA sequencing. Obviously no lights in here at the moment, but we will ultimately have standard laboratory lighting as well as UVC lights. And then behind me you can see the viewing door, which means that people who are standing outside the lab will be able to see what's happening on the inside, and that door will also be important for the safety of people working in the lab and for equipment access as well.
So although both ancient and environmental DNA allow us to address a number of important biological questions, there are challenges associated with their use. So both ancient and environmental DNA is typically damaged and degraded, and the molecules themselves are very short. So unlike contemporary or modern DNA, where the molecules might be several thousands of bases long, ancient environmental DNA, the molecules may only be a few tens of bases long. Also, the molecules themselves are very short. And so all of these attributes together mean that ancient environmental DNA is very susceptible to contamination. This contamination could come from anywhere from our own skin cells to hair or DNA that coats our clothing or other surfaces. So it could be contaminating DNA even from the family pet or from the food we've just had from lunch. And so all of these are sources of contamination that we need to exclude from analysis of ancient environmental DNA. And so to achieve this, we need a dedicated laboratory environment.
On opening, the Ædna Lab will support a wide range of ongoing projects within the University of Nottingham. We talk with PaleoRAS project leader, Matt Jones, about how sediment cores can teach us about agricultural systems of the past.
So we're here in the laboratories of the School of Geography, and this is where we keep the lake sediment cores that we use in our teaching and research. So colleagues from across the university use these kinds of samples to reconstruct how climates and environments have changed in the past over thousands of years. So these sediments are what we call varved sediments. So that means that each year two layers of sediment are laid down. So in this particular lake, each year we have a layer of calcium carbonate, so like limestone, and this is the white layer that you can see here, and this is probably deposited in the late spring or early summer in the lake. And then we have a second layer which is more sort of green in colour, green and grey in colour, and this is composed of the algae that bloom in the lake in the spring and sometimes in the autumn, and then the stuff that's washed into the lake during the winter, so during storm events. And in particular years, you have some really big storm events, or maybe even an earthquake or something, which brings more of that catchment material into the lake. So that's what these larger, thicker grey layers are in this particular bit of the core. So the Paleo Benchmarking Resilient Agricultural Systems Project, or PaleoRAS for short, is part of the university's Future Food Beacon. And we're trying to use the past in that sense to learn lessons that might help us manage the challenges, or some of the challenges, that agriculture might face in the future. When we look at how agriculture interacts with things like climate change and a growing population globally, are the lessons we can learn from how agricultural systems have looked and have worked or not worked in the past to help us plan for the future. One of the ways we can do that is use information we get from cores like this in terms of how the climate has changed, how the environment has changed, how the types of vegetation around a particular lake have changed, be that natural vegetation or agricultural vegetation or the combination of those two. And the Ædna lab is going to give us a really great way of potentially looking at that in even more detail than we can currently using more traditional proxy techniques, such as just counting pollen by eye, for example. So we're really excited to have this great new facility at the university, which is really going to help build on the work we've managed to start with the PaleoRAS project.
As with all the Future Food Beacon platforms, the Ædna lab will engage with collaborators both in the UK and across the world. For further details on how to work with us, please visit our website. The Future Food Beacon, exploring new ways of feeding the world.